I haven't set any destination for myself. Nor do I get the feeling that I am progressing towards any particular goal. I just make films the way I like, and in filmmaking, I think probably in every artistic creation, one feels that you, in the process of creating, you discover yourself and also you reveal yourself. So that process goes on.
It's been a journey of continuous discovery for Adoor Gopalakrishnan, perhaps India's most significant contemporary filmmaker. Through 8 films in 25 years, Adoor has explored life, culture and politics in Kerala with sensitivity and insight that is beyond replication. He belongs right up there among the world's best celluloid poets. Adoor has drawn his inspiration from his own experiences and life.
Well, it can start from anywhere. It can start from a character, it can start from an incident, newspaper report, it can be a dream, it can be just something that really hurt you very deeply. It can come from anywhere. And very often you wouldn't even know, where exactly it started, but then when you start thinking about it, well, you can trace it. Because that's why in every film there is an element of autobiography. It's not necessarily following the course of the real events. It has to be universal in appeal. It has to mean something for the others who watch the film.
Born in 1941 in the village of Adoor in Kerala, a southern state of India, Adoor's early passion was the stage, and he made his debut as an actor at the age of 8. His family was recognized for its patronage of Kathakali, Kerala's traditional classical theatre, and had in its midst performers and rasikas of great merit. In fact, as Kathakali artists do, Adoor has prefixed the name of his village to his own.
Kathakali is very formal, very stylized, and there is no attempt at any kind of reality. It is as far removed as anything can be from the real world. Probably there is no other theatre art which depends so much on the language of the gestures and the language of the music, the language of the rhythm, the language of the movement. In that sense, at a very, very deep level, cinema and Kathakali join hands.
Yet Adoor's form reflects an extreme economy of movement, gesture and speech. His is a naturalistic style, with an emphasis on psychological realism and earthy regionalism. Adoor graduated from the Film and Television Institute of India in 1965. He went back to Kerala and in the same year was one of the key players in the setting up of a film cooperative in Trivandrum. Adoor had already written and directed more than 20 plays. He was clear about the kind of films he wanted to make. The purpose of the initiative was to work together with Film Institute graduates and set up a production distribution center for personal cinema outside the commercial format of melodramatic Malayalam films. Swayambaram, Adoor's first film, was a direct product of the film cooperative, not just in terms of finance, but of theme.
നീ ഊണ് കഴിക്കാം, ഇനിയും വേണ്ട,
The film explores the drudgery of everyday reality of the lower middle classes. These runaway lovers move from an expensive hotel to a cheaper one, and finally, as their finances hit rock bottom, to a hut.
Arangi venda. Nyam balandira. Ba. Vaan.
The emotional impact of their predicament is sharper because the couple is educated, like almost the entire middle class in Kerala. Education for them is a twin-edged sword. Their sense of deprivation is heightened as they expect a higher standard of living. Adoor passes no moral judgment on the couple, as the typical cinema of that time might have. He points to the oppressive economic burdens they bear.
Sire. 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 Ennodu kemikku.
Swayambaram went on to win 4 national awards. Yet it was a gap of 5 years before Adoor found the money to make his second film, Kudiyattam. It is his most lyrical film. With rare poetic realism, Adoor journeys through the day-to-day life of a simpleton drifter affectionately indulged by the villagers. He learns of life by becoming a truck driver's cleaner boy. Unusual for local audiences, the film had no background musical score and instead used the natural sounds of the countryside. Adoor broke new ground in Malayalam cinema by creating a divide between the visual and the verbal, by conveying meaning through striking shots and images rather than through literary flourishes, which had so far been the trend in Kerala. His early work dealt with the human condition. It later evolved to encompass moral dilemmas in a changing world. His cinema is not didactic. It is a sharing of insights and experiences. It was Adoor's third film, Ilipathayam, The Rat Trap, that placed him firmly on the international map. From lyricism to metaphor in Ilipathayam. The rat and the rat trap are metaphors for Unni, the eldest member of a Nair family, former rent collectors of Kerala. By Adoor's own admission, the decaying feudal society and the huge ancestral house are autobiographical. Ilipathayam was also Adoor's first film in color.
I told myself that I had to use color very, very carefully because each element of color had to be to mean something. It had to promote a dramatic purpose. And I couldn't waste any color. So I had to very, very, very even deliberately, schematically used color in that film. Basically, I used red color for the youngest girl, and the eldest sister was predominantly using shades of green, and then the middle one was using blue, shades of blue. And you mix the three colors, you get the white, and I gave the man the predominantly, his shirts were white with stripes, vertical stripes. The whole thing was performed before the predominant gray of the house, the decay, you know.
You think it's a deep well? Just 10, 15 feet. Whereas in the film, you get the impression that it's a very, very deep well. You know how I did it? One of my artist's assistants, he sat down there at the bottom of it. He was just holding the rope, giving the impression that she was trying for a long, long time. And finally, he get the thing up. This is how it is.
How much the film is cheating?
Well, as long as you are driving at the reality, you want to give the impression it is justified. Actually, it's not cheating. It's just playing on their gullibility. It's not really cheating. I wouldn't want to cheat the audience. I want to be frank. I'm recreating an inner reality, not an exterior reality.
The intellectual integrity of this director allows him to see the evolution of his own family as a mirror to the turbulent social history of Kerala.
I was going through a very difficult period in my life, very, very bad emotional crisis I had, and I thought it was a good time to look at myself very cruelly, very incisively, and the result was a script which I wrote almost in one go. It's a probing as to why we do not respond naturally.
Kochata.
Eh, entuva?
Ayyo, kochata padukke. Kallamara.
Ayyo, kallamara.
Aga thalla kochata. Velile thenga vettikondu ponnu. Kochata nu nenite.
Yano. Ippa irangi chellano. Nee entha nai parayne?
Enna thenga ella kallamara kondu otte.
Ningalku chumma thoniyadayirikku.
വേണ്ട വീഴുന്നു പിന്നെയും തേങ്ങ
അത് വല്ല പെരിച്ചാതിയും വെള്ളക്കാതെ തട്ടിയിടുന്നതായിരിക്കും നിങ്ങൾ പോയി കിടന്ന് ഉറങ്ങി
From the social to the political dimension of change was a small step. Mukhamukham is divided into two parts. The first deals with the period just before the 1957 victory of the Communist Party in the state. Sridharan is an idealistic union leader and Marxism, the hope of the young. The film is about the weaknesses of the left, not just in Kerala, but in India. The public face of communism collapses in the face of individual frailty. It is this dual element that Mukhamukham stands for. The leaders of the movement disregard the truth even as it laughs them in the face. The divorce between ideology and actuality causes the collapse of the movement. Certainly, Mukhamukham is Adoor's most controversial film for its setting in the politics of Kerala. But for him, it is the evolution of a vision, film by film, as he examines different aspects of the society he lives in. He is not just a filmmaker, but a social historian, even if his realm is fiction.
Well, story is just an excuse to keep you interested in what is going on the screen, whereas the concerns are outside the plot outline. When you make a film in Kerala, you have to necessarily have the politics as at least the background of what is going on, because unless you show that interaction between political ideology and the lives lived here, you will be making some very untrue statements. My political ideology can be explained as a certain kind of humanism, not beyond that.
Even in fiction, the secret of Adoor's success is his commitment to truth. He takes all his stories, his characters, his situations, from his own milieu, his own village, his own life. Authenticity is the bulwark on which his work rests. Adoor's next quest was that of the psychological. He drew on his memories of childhood, adolescence, and young adulthood. The profound influences from these three stages of his life in the cultural milieu of Kerala play their part in Anantharam. At first, the wonders of childhood and the innocent absorbing of the immediate environment. Adoor has sequences from the three periods of Ajayan's life, not in logical or chronological order, but in one that reveals the character's confusion and the gradual disintegration of personality.
നിനക്കിച്ചിരി പതുക്കെ നടന്നുടായോ ചവിട്ടിയെ ഉപ്പാട് വന്നു പോയല്ലോ എന്തോന്നാ വിളിച്ചേ ചേച്ചി എന്ന് വിളിക്കാമെന്ന് ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞിട്ടില്ലല്ലോ
ആ അതിപ്പം മനസ്സിലിരിക്കട്ടെ ഈ നോവലും കൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ രണ്ട് ദിവസം ഇവിടെ നടക്കുന്നു
നല്ലതാണോ
ആ
അതെന്താ
ഓ ഇതൊന്നും നടക്കുന്നൊന്നുമല്ല
ആ അല്ലല്ലോ അജയൻ ഒരൊറ്റ പുസ്തകം കൊള്ളാന്ന് പറയത്തില്ലല്ലോ ഞാനൊന്ന് വായിച്ചു നോക്കട്ടെ
The cocky teenager bears little similarity to the brooding young adult he grows into. The journey of life being so uncertain and the development of personality so terribly subjective. Destiny has something else in store for the young man. Depression and perhaps mental illness.
ഞാൻ ഒരു കോൺഫറൻസിന് വന്നതാ. പിന്നെ നിന്നെ കാണാമല്ലോ എന്നുള്ളതായിരുന്നു മറ്റൊരു ടെംപ്റ്റേഷൻ. കോൺഫറൻസ് ഉച്ചയ്ക്ക് മുമ്പേ തീർന്നു. ബാക്കി ദിവസത്തേക്കുള്ള പ്ലാനിങ്ങും സുമ നടത്തി കഴിഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നു. ഇനിയിപ്പോ ഒരു സിനിമ കാണണം പിന്നെ നല്ലൊരു ചൈനീസ് റെസ്റ്റോറന്റ് തിരക്കി പിടിച്ച് ഒരു ഡിന്നർ
In many ways, Anantharam is about how the protagonist has a sort of disassociation between his intellectual and emotional processes. This is not Adoor's life, certainly, but the commonality of human experience that he draws upon constantly. His films seem deceptively simple in narrative and structure, as each one probes a serious concern, striking universal resonances. Inspired by Gandhi, there is an economy and a simplicity in both his lifestyle and in his work. A palpable conviction permeates his work. When this mingles with the vision of a poet and the heart of a social chronicler, it can only light up the screen. Mathilokal was Adoor's first film based on a story by another author. Shot entirely within the walls of a prison, the film is notable for the absence of a visible female character. One hears her voice across the wall, but is never sure whether she isn't really a figment of the writer-protagonist's imagination. Women have always been portrayed with strong character in Adoor's films, sometimes even stronger than men. There is also a degree of repressed sexuality in the man-woman relationship.
Narayani!
Enda vendathu?
Oh!
Pinnallade. Kambarnu kaiyada kola paranju.
Njan tadavi seripadutha.
Enna kai? Tadavi seripadutha. Njan madili kollichu vechirikkya.
Njan ee madilil tadavunnundu. ചുംബിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്
ഞാൻ മതിലിൽ നെഞ്ച് അമർത്തി അമർത്തി ചുംബിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്.
നാരായണി, അവിടെ എത്ര സ്ത്രീകളുണ്ട്?
ഞാൻ മാത്രമേ ഉള്ളൂ.
കള്ളി പെണ്ണേ, നേര് പറയൂ, എത്ര എണ്ണം ഉണ്ട്?
കുറേ ഉണ്ട്, എല്ലാം പടുകിഴവികളാ.
എത്ര?
87.
സുന്ദരികൾ എത്ര, കിഴവികൾ എത്ര?
ഒരു സുന്ദരിയും 86 കിഴവികളും.
ഐ ഗ്രൂ അപ്പ് ഇൻ എ സിംഗിൾ പേരന്റ് സിറ്റുവേഷൻ. ദർ ആർ സോ മെനി ഫാമിലീസ് ഇൻ കേരള വെയർ വിമൻ ടേക്ക് ദി ലീഡ് ആൻഡ് ദെൻ ബ്രിങ് അപ് ദെയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ. They may suffer themselves, but then they see that the children get good education. And in Kerala particularly, households can really stand on its own, you know, when even when a woman of the house is the head of the family. This happens, this is very normal. It is not necessarily a feminist situation, you know, where the woman is fighting for her rights and for equal rights with the man. Not necessarily. But in Kerala's matrilineal system allowed the woman a prominent place in the joint family.
എന്തൊക്കെയാ ബാച്ചുള്ള വിശേഷം? ഒരുപാട് നാളായല്ലോ.
കൂപ്പിലായിരുന്നേ.
കൂപ്പിലെ പണിയൊക്കെ കഴിഞ്ഞു?
കഴിഞ്ഞേ.
ഇയാടെ പെണ്ണും പിള്ള പെറ്റതറിഞ്ഞോ? അഞ്ചാറ് മാസമായി. പെണ്ണ
കൂപ്പിലെ പണി കഴിഞ്ഞപ്പം മടത്തിക്കാര് ആനയങ്ങ് വിറ്റു. കൊച്ചിനെ കാണാൻ വരുമ്പം വെറും കൈയോടെ എങ്ങനെയാ വരുന്നേന്ന് വിചാരിച്ചു.
അതിന് ഇതിയാടെ ഭാര്യ വീടൊന്നും അല്ലല്ലോ.
It is not merely human characters in Adoor's films that hold center stage, but the spaces he uses as well.
I went around so many places and none of the houses had the right ambience. Then it occurred to me, well, maybe I had this house in my mind probably when I wrote it. I don't know, it was just kind of involuntary thing that was happening, not a deliberate act. Finally settled on shooting here. And I realized this is the house where I was born and I spent a part of my childhood here. And I have many memories associated with this house and the surroundings. So all that had already gone into the script. And the house was very much an inseparable part of the whole film. There also I decided that I will have long, long takes. I never show the house in full anywhere in a long shot. The house itself was just evolving like the other characters.
Mone, nee endina eppozhum aa kochinodu valakku undakkune?
Adoor's work is finely etched, remarkable for its precision and control, even as it retains the intensity of his quest, while the exploration and the thematic content of his films increasingly touched inner depths. Some things have remained the same. Adoor writes his own scripts, and in Malayalam, the language he knows best. Despite many offers, he has refused to work in any other language.
Illibara baddi magane. ഇവിടെ വാടാ, നായിന്റെ മോനെ.
വിധേയൻ എക്സ്പ്ലോർസ് ദി ഇന്റർഡിപെൻഡൻസ് ഓഫ് പവർ ആൻഡ് സിവിലിറ്റി, ഡോക്യുമെന്റിംഗ് റിയൽ ഫ്യൂഡലിസം. ഓൾ കൾച്ചേഴ്സ് വിത്ത് എ ഫ്യൂഡൽ മെമ്മറി കൻ ഐഡന്റിഫൈ വിത്ത് ഇറ്റ്.
എന്താണടാ നിന്റെ മട്ടേ കയ്യില്?
ഒന്നുമില്ലേ.
പിന്നെ എന്തിനാടാ പട്ടി നീ ഇവരുടെ കൈ പുറകിൽ പിടിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്?
നിനക്ക് ടൂറാനുമുട്ടുന്നുണ്ടോ?
ബഹുമാനിക്കേണ്ടവരെ കണ്ടാൽ നിനക്ക് ബഹുമാനിക്കാൻ അറിഞ്ഞൂടെ?
ഇങ്ങ് അടുത്തു വാടാ.
When a film, a work of art, is very close to the real life and situations that exist in a very specific area at a very specific time, it is very genuine. By being regional, it doesn't exclude the rest of the humanity. Here are the issues which I feel very strongly about. When I do not feel very strongly about a subject, and I do not know much about the subject itself, I don't attempt a film.
Enda mane kariyene ende kunjine vikkan aanu parna aarengil aakshepicho
alla adalla
pinne
pelile ramakrishna sir kunjune amane petti busha nu vilichu
endo nu vilichana
petti busha class il ellarum kuda kaliyaaki chirichu
അല്ലേലു ആ കിട്ടഞ്ചോന്റെ മോൻ രാമകൃഷ്ണൻ വാത്യാർ ഒരു അഹങ്കാരിയാ. ഇന്നാളൊരു ദിവസേ ഇവിടുത്തെ വാതുക്കെ കൂടെ ചെരുപ്പിട്ടോണ്ട് പോകുന്നു. കാലം പോയ പോക്കെ
കണ്ട വാതി കാണാത്ത വാതി ഞാനിങ്ങ് കേറിപ്പോന്നു. ആ കാന്തി ഒരുത്തനാ ഇതിനെല്ലാം കാരണം. എല്ലാരും ഒരുപോലെ ആന്ന് പോലും.
Time and history play an important role in Adoor's films. An overtly metaphorical film, Kathapurushan is the culmination of many of Adoor's lifelong concerns about politics, culture, social status, love and individual freedom. It weaves a historical perspective into the personal.
സത്യത്തിന്റെ മുഖം എത്ര വികൃതം. അപ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് ആരെയും തൊടാതെയും ഒന്നിനെയും അനക്കാതെയും എന്തെങ്കിലും ചെയ്യാം. എന്താ? ഒളിച്ച്, ഒതുക്കി, മറച്ച്, ഭയന്ന്, വിറച്ച്.
അമ്മേ കേട്ടോ, അച്ഛൻ വിൽക്കുന്നില്ല, അച്ഛന് വിൽക്കില്ല.
I always had the kind of money I needed to make the film I had in my mind. So this is one thing I'm happy about. I never compromised because I had to limit my budget. I had to make do with what was available. No, never so. It is not the tools that make the film, you know, it is the mind. When you have a limitation with the access or availability of the sophisticated equipments, then your mind becomes even more active to utilize what is available and express what you have in your mind.
Adoor's films reflect a complete mastery of his form. There is great attention to detail. Apart from the range of subjects he handles, very few Indian films are such complete auteur films as his are.
You are lucky if there is an audience that responds to your work. We have the concept of the rasika. The rasika is one who is equipped with the knowledge of the form of the art. So you need a rasika to be responding to your work.
As Adoor pauses between films, memories and insights of the enigmas of life strike new chords and a new ordering for a new film to come.
Anjida